Hi everyone, this is Ben, and today I'm going to show you how to use our Color Picker and Color Widget tools. First, I select my object, and in the Inspector menu here on the right, I can already see these two color options for Fill and Stroke. By clicking on the color well, a new popover window opens on the side, allowing me to change the shape's color in a very precise and easy way. There are two modes here, the Color Picker with the color wheel, or the Color Slider with individual RGB and HSB sliders. But let's look at the Color Picker first. Up at the top, you can keep either a solid fill by clicking on the left button, or choose a gradient by clicking the button on the right. This will give you the option to choose between two different gradient styles. Once a gradient is selected, the content-aware option to change the two transitioning colors appears. So now I have a gradient from white to black. But we'll talk about gradients in a separate video. This is just a quick run-through. Below that, we have the color wheel and color slider, which, when combined, can render almost any color imaginable. Let's look at an example. I can use the slider here to go into the blue spectrum, and then I can give it a different shade by dragging this dot around until I'm happy with the result. This is the alpha channel slider, which tweaks the opacity of my color from fully opaque to fully transparent. One row down is the hex code. Each hex code refers to a very specific color, which allows for multiple designers or developers to be on the same page about the exact shade they intend to use. And under that, we can see our color history, which shows us the most recent colors we've used. Down here, we have the color palette section, where you can save the colors of your project super easily by clicking on the plus button while your desired color is selected. Anything down below, like blends and adjustments, will be covered in a more advanced color video, so stay tuned for that. But let's go back to the color slider. The numbers of these four channels pinpoint the exact color you're using, much like the hex code. R, G, and B define the colors, and A, or the alpha channel, represents the opacity. Here is where we can switch to using the HSB color system, which is considered a much more user-friendly way of describing color. H stands for hue, S stands for saturation, and B for brightness. In the end, it's 100% your choice the way you define your colors. All these options are available for you to try out. Okay, now let's move on to stroke. The tab looks almost identical, with the exception that you can't apply a gradient. Fill and stroke can be turned on and off by clicking on the toggle. And naturally, you can only change the color of either the fill or the stroke if these toggles are turned on. While the inspector works just fine, we've developed a brand new color widget that helps you change the color of your design in a much more fluid way, and you can find it right down here. The upper color bubble is for the fill. Clicking on it reveals the color picker. The bottom bubble controls the stroke. You can easily turn these on and off as well. And a really fun thing is that you can swap between the fill and stroke colors by right-clicking on the widget itself. The last thing I want to show you is the Eyedropper tool. This is going to be your best friend when you're replicating or adapting color references. Simply select it and then click anywhere on the canvas to pick up that particular hue. Now you can use it, save it, and edit it as you want. That's all for this topic. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to check out the rest of our tutorials to keep on learning how to use Vectornator. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in our next video. Bye!